From Australia, the Newsboys with Darlene last summer on Victory Videos.
Hi, I'm Darlene Thomas on Victory Videos, and I'm here at the ICFES Festival. I'm standing here with two of the Newsboys. I have John and Peter.
Hello.
Great to have you guys with us.
It's good to be here.
Okay, you guys are originally from Australia. Can you kind of tell us what prompted you to come to the States and tour here?
Well, we've kind of, I guess it really started with us because Australia is a big country, but it's a lot of country and not many people. You know, we've got like 15 million people in Australia, and that's as many as what, like John's explained it yesterday, I guess he summed it up, there was more people here than what's in our hometown, you know, so that kind of freaked us out. And also it really helped us here with the, I guess even the, with the scriptures, it says a prophet's accepted more in another country. And we found that coming over here, it was really exciting because people really, they were into the Australian thing and the accent and that sort of thing, and not just to use that for us, but if we could use that to glorify Jesus Christ. Yeah, that was really something that really hit us hard. You know, if we, it's like when Americans come to Australia, I think Australians listen to them more because it's kind of a different culture, or someone from a different culture. It's always, the grass is always greener on the other side, you know, so people listen to someone from another country, and, yeah, and we found that, you know, we were very well receptive here.
That's good, that's good. John, what is the real meaning behind your name, the Newsboys? What, how did you guys come up with that name? What is
I guess it's two meanings. One, the first one is that it's easy for us to spell. And the second is that we're about spreading the good news, and we're all boys, so we're the Newsboys. I guess if we were girls, we'd be called the News Girls.
Okay, what's the main message you wish to convey behind all your music?
The main message of the band is definitely to stand up for Jesus Christ, you know, to have the guts to stand up for Jesus, because it does take guts to stand up for Jesus Christ, you know. I mean, hell is for wimps, you know, that's going to be the title of our new album. And it's not the, as in a wimpy guy, as in someone who's skinny or pure, because it's not a physical thing, you know, it's all inside. It does take guts. I mean, anyone can have a mohawk, you know. I mean, I had one when I was 15 years old, you know, and I thought, well, yeah, I'm heavy, you know, I got a mohawk, you know. But what happened is that that's not what it's about. It's the real guts comes from the inside, and to stand up for Jesus Christ. And we've been, as a band, we've really accepted that, and we've decided that, like the Bible says, you know, our life here is just like a vapor, you know, and we want to catch that vision of heaven and realize that we're only here for a short time, you know, and go crazy for Jesus Christ. You know, I don't want to be in heaven and God says, well, well done, my good and faithful servant, but you know that, or even you're on your deathbed and you know that you could have done a lot more. You could have really sold out 100%, because let's face it, we all know that Jesus Christ is real. We know that God's real because people cry out to him. You know, you're about to get wasted in a car accident, or you fear something bad's going to happen to you. You don't cry out, oh, Buddha, or oh, Hare Krishna, you know. No, everyone cries out to God because in the heart of man, they know that there is a God and they know that it's true, you know. And that's something that we've really found, that, you know, we've got to really discipline ourselves to realize and be 100% sold out for Jesus Christ, because as soon as you decide that, man, it's exciting life. Yeah. That's what Christianity is about, you know.
We'll be right back.
Stay tuned for more VTV and the Newsboys and music update right after this.
Man, the Newsboys on Victory Videos.
Can you kind of tell us about the spiritual condition of Australia? Is there a spiritual awakening going on, any revival happening in Australia?
There's a real move in Australia, especially amongst the young people. Like we said before, there's only like 15 million people in the whole country, and probably only about 2% of that go to church, and maybe a quarter of that are really practicing Christians. So there's not many Christians, and the ones that are standing up for Jesus Christ are totally sold out for God. But the Newsboys, it's been a real privilege. We've been able to be a part of what God's moving, and in the last year or so, we've seen literally thousands upon thousands of young kids, school kids, teenagers coming to know the Lord. So we're excited. God's really moving in Australia.
That's really great. And I understand you guys are going to be having a trip to Australia so people can get involved and they can experience some of this. You want to tell us about that, Peter?
Yeah, well, that's something we've always felt, you know, we've never wanted to leave. Although we can't tour in Australia all our lives, we've really felt with our hearts still in our own country as well. And what, like I said before, because you're accepted, foreigners are accepted really well in Australia, just like they are here. Well, Australians are accepted here. We've really felt that it'd be great to take a lot of Americans back to the, like, Australian Aboriginals and just everyday, you know, Joe Blog Australians too, you know, and take it back and go through different parts of Australia. So we are taking a tour to Australia in January 1991. And there's not many tickets left, but there's going to be a 1-800 number that's going to come up on the screen. See, just under there. And it's going to come up on the screen, and that's the number you can call and to find out information on the trip. Yeah.
That's great. We want to thank you guys from down under, and it's really been great having you. I really enjoyed your performance here. And
We've loved being here.
Yeah, thanks a lot, mate.
Thanks. And I'm Darlene Thomas, and that's more on Victory Videos.
I'm Howard Finster. I'm just a simple man with a simple message. People would be, there is a living God, there is eternal hell, and there's an eternal heaven, and that their need, that the greatest need of theirs is understanding. I'm uneducated. I never got no education. I was only in the sixth grade. And therefore, I wasn't produced by this world. I can look at that fan wheel turning right down there. That's God. There wouldn't be a peck of air here if it wasn't for God. That's my job here, is to show people who God is, and what he is, and where he's at. And that I can do.
How'd you like the Newsboys? Good music from the Newsboys, and more Victory videos coming up right after this.
Life is a series of choices. What you eat, how you look, whether you do drugs or not. You know, cocaine, crack. See, only you can decide, because the only person responsible is you. Now, if you make the right choice, there's nothing you can't accomplish. If you make the wrong choice, all your other decisions are made for you.
Well, that's our show today. It's great to see how God's hand influences people's lives all over our world. And you know, even in your city today, let him be a part of your life today. And I'd like to encourage you to write to us, because we want to hear what Christ is doing in your life. Our address is Victor Videos, 6800 Hazel Court, Florence, Kentucky, 41042. There it is on your screen. Victor Videos, 6800 Hazel Court, Florence, Kentucky, 41042. We are in the Cincinnati area, if you're seeing this out of this area. You know, Jesus loves you today, and so do we. Don't forget that. That's what we're here for. Dave Dobbins saying, remember to love somebody today with the love of Jesus. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.